Welcome into a brand new F1 Gamer Dad video. We are today bridging the gap between Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 and the brand new Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024. Now, I will preface this video by saying I haven't done too much in 2024 as yet for me, and I know there's been a lot of mixed experiences online and a lot of Reddit posts and a lot of complaining about the Sims state in general. Because of that, I am staying away for a little while longer to do some decent flying. However, I had an interesting comment flash up on my previous video, which I've linked to on the left side of the screen here, which was how to create a custom livery for the Fenix A320 on Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. Now, the comment asked, how do I do this in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024? And my response was, actually, I'm not too sure. So I was very curious, extremely curious, I would elevate that to figure out how to, because I had done a bit of poking around and I had only the base liveries and the third-party liveries that you can find off flightsim.to as well. So I made it a mission to go find out. I will say, I spent an inordinate amount of time on this. I would say in the realms of about 3 or 4 hours of trial and error before I actually figured out how to do it. So I'm hoping this video here can save you a lot of that trial and error time messing around. I think I relocated my community folders 6 times. I uninstalled 2024 3 times. I actually uninstalled 2020 at a certain point in time just to see if something was potentially putting it out of balance. I messed around with existing folders. I added new folders. I looked up instructions. I contacted Fenix Sim as well, who were super helpful, but also said that because they aren't fully compatible with 2024 as yet, they couldn't necessarily give a definitive answer on where to look or how to get this done in the first place. So, with all that in mind, I did find a resolution, so we will jump into Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 momentarily to just look at the process, and it's a simple process. So again, I've done all the running around for you. I want to show you that it's nothing to be scared of if you are in an all-in on 2024, or if you're dabbling in doing the odd flight here or there. It is definitely worthwhile doing this to get your own custom liveries in the sim, and it shouldn't take longer than I'm going to say. If you've already created a livery for the Fenix A320 in 2020, this should take you 1.5 to 2 minutes max. And then obviously you've got the 10 minutes that the sim takes to load, which was obviously half of my trial and error time just waiting for 2024 to load up again. At one point, I actually got stuck on the 97% bug, and that took a crazy amount of time to resolve as well. So without further ado, let's open 2024 and get cracking. So the first thing we need to do when we open up Microsoft Flight Simulator 2024 is to go to the marketplace. Now, I know the marketplace hasn't been implemented yet, so we're going up top here, clicking My Library. And then over on the right-hand side of the page, we've got a cog icon, which will bring up our settings menu. And then you've got this big file path here. You can hit browse and you can find your community folder. Okay, if you want to change this, pressing browse, going into the file menu, you can open up or create a new folder to change your community folder. So you can have it on the C drive, or you can have it on an external drive, whatever suits you best. So I did trial and error that. Unfortunately, the D drive or my external drive did not work. I had plenty of issues there, so I've kept it on the C drive for the purpose of this. And you'll see what I've done is I've opened up the new community folder. I've got that open in one window here. And this is how easy it is. It boils down to this. Open up your existing 2020 community folder. Find your paint or your livery folder with all the different PNGs and .DDSs in there. Okay, I've got them side by side here and I've checked over them, so they're definitely the files with the livery inside. Go back out to the base folder and we're simply going to drag it across. Now, copying and pasting this, for me at least, did not work. It actually came up with an error saying you don't have permission to copy this folder and paste it into this community folder. So that was an issue. But as you'll see, dragging it across, it has gone into the community folder. I've double checked the community folder has those files in there now as well. You will need to restart the sim. For the purpose of this video, I didn't want to have any load screens popping up and convoluting things, so I have opened it up again. And what we'll see is we've got our aircraft here in the menu from the free flight page, and you will find an Airbus A320 Fenix sim aircraft in your airplane folder. If we click on this and hit configure, you'll notice when this loads up, so there we go, we've got our livery, it's done. You'll notice though, liveries don't show for these different variants. The new livery for me has come up as a new variant. So the template and the paint kit that I used was the all white paint kit that you'll remember from my 2020 video. That is the variant, so it's not a different livery. Liveries are from the Fenix Livery Manager. The variants are the separate aircraft that you're going to create through the paint kit that you're going to create a livery for. That's it. Okay, we're done. You've seen it in the menu. The livery is there. I'm going to quickly load up into Amsterdam to show you this on the ground. And I'm going to magically skip past all the weirdness that I get when I spawn into an airport, either on a runway or at a gate or at a parking bay. A lot of just really weird stuff that I get from the sim. But as you can see, we have eventually loaded up into Microsoft Flight Sim 2024 with our great livery, one that I am very, very proud of. We've got our wingspan wobbling and bubbling about there. We do have to load up on the ground, which I still find very strange for a captain to have to do a walk around on the tarmac of his twin jet. But there you see it. The livery is applied. And like I said, it's taken us a minute, maybe 2 minutes max, to send that folder over to the original folder. And we've done the job. So I really hope that's been super easy for everyone to follow. If there's any comments or anything that's not working, I'm still learning this as well, please comment whatever the issue is, and we'll try and sort it out. We'll try and find a resolution for you. I am in dialogue with the Fenix sim team as well to just see if we can get a really easy to use manual or instruction set for this. So yeah, anything that pops up, please send that through in the comments. Apart from that, that is the full length and full context of this video. I hope that's been helpful. We've ported and bridged the gap from Microsoft Flight Sim 2020 to 2024, and we've got our custom liveries all set. We're ready to go flying. So until the next video, keep flying, have fun up there, and we'll see you next time.